स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस स्टार्ट आवर डिस्कशन अबाउट LCR सीरीज सर्किट. एज वी हैव सीन इन AC वोल्टेज अप्लाइड टू अ रेसिस्टर, व्हाट विल बी द फेज रिलेशन बिटवीन द करंट फ्लोइंग थ्रू द रेसिस्टर एंड द अप्लाइड वोल्टेज. ऑल्सो वी हैव सीन दैट व्हाट विल द फेज रिलेशन ऑफ द करंट फ्लोइंग थ्रू द इंडक्टर टू द अप्लाइड AC वोल्टेज इन द इंडक्टर. Also in the case of capacitor, we have also seen what is the phase relation of the current flowing through the capacitor and the voltage applied to a capacitor. And also we have discussed the average power loss in one complete cycle and a half complete cycle in resistor, capacitor and inductor. And we have found that the resistance of the circuit by which the power is lost in the and also the voltage is dropped across the resistor is R, that is resistance. And the factor by which the voltage is dropped across the inductor is known as IXL. And the unit of reactive inductance is ohm. And also the voltage drop in the capacitor is found out due to the capacitive reactance that plays the same role as the resistance of a resistor. So the unit of the capacitive reactance, that is represented by XC, is also have a unit of ohm. Now let us discuss the LCR series circuit. And in this circuit we have discussed that what will be the phase of the current flowing through LCR series circuit to the supplied voltage. And also we have discussed that what will be the total resistance of the circuit. It means that is known as impedance. So we have discussed all these topic under this topic. So let us start our discussion. Suppose that we have an inductor and a capacitor and a resistor. So if they are connected in series, the inductance of the inductor is L, the capacitance of the capacitor is C, and the resistance of the resistor is R. If they are connected in series through an AC voltage source whose potential at an instant of time is given by the formula V equal to Vm sin omega t. So as we connect this circuit and current is allowed to flow through the inductor, capacitor and the resistor, then at an instant of time, if we find out the current flowing through the inductor is I and also capacitor is I and resistor is I, then at that time the total potential drop across the inductor is LdI by dt. And during flowing of current through the capacitor starts charging. So at an instant of time, if the charge stores across the plates of the capacitor is Q, then the potential across the capacitor will be equal to Q by C. And if the current flowing through the resistor is I, then the potential drop across the resistor will be I into R. So according to Kirchhoff's law, the supplied voltage, that is V, will be equal to the potential drop across inductor plus potential drop across capacitor plus potential drop across resistor. So this is LdI by dt, this is Q by C, and this one is I into R. Okay, so if at an instant of time this is I, so we can write it as, for the voltage equation, LdI by dt is plus potential drop across resistor, that is IR, plus Q by C is equal to V, that is Vm sin omega t. Okay, so this is the equation for the potential. If we solve and find out a relation for the current, then what will be the phase of the current with the supplied potential source? We can discuss this by two different manner. One by phasor diagram relation and other by analytical solution. So first we start our discussion with the help of the analytical solution. Okay, so to solve this equation, if we write this I as the rate of flow of charge and this I is also rate of flow of charge, this I can be expressed as dq by dt, and this di by dt will be expressed as d2q by dt square. So with the help of this we get the equation is this L d2q by dt square plus r dot dq by dt plus q by c is equal to v or vm sin omega t. So this is a second order differential equation. To getting a particular solution of this equation, let us assume that the amount of the charge can be expressed as we know that the charge stores across the capacitor is changes its value with respect to time, and also this must be take some phase with respect to the potential source, applied potential source. So if we take a particular solution of this equation is as q equal to qm, this is the maximum charge stored across the capacitor, sine of omega t plus phi or theta. Okay, so let us assume that if the theta is the phase makes by the charge with respect to the potential, so if we assume that this is a particular solution of this equation, then we want to calculate what will be the value of this qm and also what will be the value of this theta. This can be calculated by putting the value of q at this place and dq by dt by differentiating it and putting at this plate, and second order differentiating this and putting at this place. So if you differentiate it, then we get dq by dt is equal to omega comes out from here, sine becomes cos, so omega into qm cos of omega t plus theta, and again if you differentiate it, then we get d2q by dt square is equal to again omega comes out and cos becomes minus of sine, so this becomes omega square qm sine of omega t plus theta. Okay, so if we put all these three value of q and dq by dt and d2q by dt square in this equation, suppose that this is equation number 1, then we get a particular equation l into d2q by dt square, that is minus of omega square qm, so minus of omega square qm into sine of omega t plus theta plus r dot omega qm into cos omega t, r dot omega qm into cos omega t plus theta plus this q by c, q means qm sin omega t, so this becomes qm sin omega t plus theta by c is equal to v. Okay, so this is the equation. Now if we solve this equation or summarize this equation, then we get, as we are seeing that omega qm is common in all term, then we get omega qm, and from here we get minus omega dot l, minus omega l sine of omega t plus theta, and here is also sine omega plus theta. So if you take sine omega t plus theta as common, sine of omega t plus theta is common, then from here we get minus L dot omega, and from here if we are taking omega and qm as common, so here is not any omega, so by multiplying and divide, this omega qm becomes at outside from the equation, and this omega in denominator is left out, so this becomes 1 upon omega c. Okay, and this term omega and qm is taken outside, so from here we get r dot cos of omega t plus theta and this is equal to V. Okay, as we know that omega L is equal to XL and 1 upon omega C is equal to XC. This is the inductive reactance and this one is the capacitive reactance. So after putting the value of this, we get minus XL plus XC. So we can write it as XC minus XL. So we get omega into QM XC minus XL into sine of omega t plus theta plus r into cos of omega t plus theta is equal to V. So if we rearrange this and write this term before and this one is at after, so we get omega into QM r into cos of omega t plus theta plus XC minus XL sine of omega t plus theta equal to V. So as we are seeing that XC and XL have the dimension of resistance and R is itself a resistance, so the unit of R is ohm, and XC minus XL has also unit of ohm. So if we replace this R and XC minus XL by some another quantity which has a constant value, but making it in some trigonometric function, so like it, if we assume that R is written in terms of another value that have a unit of resistance, that is ohm, so R equal to Z of cos phi, and XC minus XL is equal to Z of sin phi. Here phi is the some angle, and that can be calculated what will be the value of phi and what will be the value of Z. If we solve this, then from here, if we squaring all these two equation and by summing, we get Z square equal to R square plus XC minus XL whole square. So from here, we get Z equal to under root R square plus XC minus XL whole square. And the unit of this Z is just ohm. And what will be the value of this phi? The value of phi will be calculated by dividing this equation by this equation. So Z and Z will be cancelled, and sin phi by cos phi becomes tan phi. So tan of phi will be equal to XC minus XL by R. XC minus XL by R. So this will be two substitution by us in this equation. So this equation reduces to omega QM. And if we replace this R by Z cos phi, then and XC minus XL by Z sin phi, then Z is common in both term. So Z can be taken outside from both term. And here this becomes cos phi into cos of omega t plus theta plus this becomes sin phi into sin of omega t plus theta equal to V. And this can be rewritten as omega into QM into Z equal to, this is cos A cos B plus sin A sin B, it means cos A minus B. As we know that cos A minus B equal to cos B minus A, because cos of minus theta equal to cos theta. So this can be taken as A and this can be taken as B. So this becomes cos of omega t plus theta minus phi. Okay, so this is the value of this, and it is equal to V. So as we know that the value of this V is equal to Vm sin of omega t. So for comparing the value of the argument and the coefficient of this sign, okay, so this cos must be converted into sine. So we can convert it into sine and can be written as omega into QM into Z, and this be written as sine of, then as we know that sine of 90 plus theta equal to cos of theta. So if we put sine 90 plus theta, then the sine of the omega t will be maintained as positive. So if we put sine 90 minus theta, then this is also equal to cos theta. But when we put sine 90 minus theta, then we get omega t has a negative sign. So this will be not equal to comparable with this. So putting sine 90 plus theta, so this becomes 90 plus, and this one is omega t plus theta minus phi. Okay, this is equal to Vm sine omega t. Okay, so now this equation is comparable. If we compare the coefficient, then we get Vm is equal to omega Qm into Z. And if we compare the argument, then we get omega t is equal to pi by 2 plus omega t plus theta minus phi. Okay, so after comparing it, what we get? Now, after comparing, we get that Vm is equal to omega into Qm into Z. As we know that V, that is potential, and it can be defined as the product of the current into resistance. So as we know that the unit of Z is unit of resistance, so this omega into Qm has the unit of current, so this omega into Qm can be reduces to Im. So this Vm is equal to Im into Z, where Im is equal to omega into Qm. From here Im is equal to Vm by Z, and from here what will be the value of Z? This is R square plus XC minus XL ka whole square. Okay, so this is Vm R square plus XC minus XL whole square. Okay, so this is the value of Im. Now what will be the value of Im in maximum condition? It means what will be the maximum value of this Im? This can be maximum only when the denominator will be minimum and denominator will be minimum until XC is equal to XL. And when X is not equal to XL, the value of Im does not get its maximum value, that is Im max. So for Im max, XC must be equal to XL, and this at XC must be equal to XL, it means 1 upon omega C is equal to 1 upon omega L, and at that particular frequency on which the current becomes its maximum value, current attains its maximum value, that condition is known as resonance. Okay, so this is 1 upon omega C, and suppose that at that frequency, the frequency is written as by omega naught, this is equal to omega naught L. So from here omega naught is equal to 1 by under root LC. This frequency is known as resonance frequency, and this condition is known as resonance. So at that, if this equal to this, then the XC minus XL becomes 0. So at that condition, the value of Im max will be equal to Vm divided by R only, because the value of Z becomes R. It means the impedance of the circuit is minimum, that is the value that is always equal to the resistance of the circuit. So this Z is termed as a particular name, that is known as impedance. Okay, Z is known as impedance. It means the total resistance of the LCR series circuit. Now if we talk about the phasor diagram for the equation and the comparing value of the theta obtained at here, now as we obtained it here that sine of omega t and here sine of pi by 2 plus omega t plus theta plus minus phi. So after comparing it, we get again comparing the argument. This is the comparison of the coefficient. And this is the comparison of the argument. So from here we get pi by 2 plus omega t plus theta minus phi is equal to omega t. So we are seeing that omega t is in same sign, either of the equal sign, and this will be cancelled to each other. So from here we get theta minus phi is equal to minus of pi by 2. So from here we get theta equal to what? Theta equal to phi. Here phi is negative, so that side becomes positive. Phi minus pi by 2. Okay. So the value of theta is phi minus pi by 2. So if you put the value of theta, as we know that q equal to qm sine of omega t plus theta, and from here we get I equal to dq by dt. So by differentiating it, we get omega into qm into cos of omega t plus theta. So this omega into qm, as we assume that it has im, so this I is equal to im and cos of omega t plus theta. So if you put the value of theta as theta phi minus pi by 2, so this is phi minus pi by 2. Then if you take minus as common from the argument, then this becomes im into cos of minus of, and this becomes pi by 2 minus, all both term becomes negative, it means omega t plus phi. Okay, so as we know that cos minus of theta equal to cos theta, so this minus becomes disappear, so this equal to im cos of pi by 2 minus omega t plus theta phi. Okay, so this will be the equation. Now so the value of this current will be equal to im, and we know that cos 90 minus theta is equal to sin theta, so this becomes im of sin of omega t plus phi. Okay, so we will obtain finally the equation for the current flowing through LCR series circuit. Now we are seeing that the potential applied across the LCR series circuit is V equal to Vm sin omega t, and the current that flows through the LCR series circuit is obtained as by the equation Im sin omega t plus phi. So let us discuss some more. So from here we can get some more concept. If we write this V equal to Vm sin omega t as first equation, as from here, and I equal to Im sin omega t plus phi, this is as second equation from here, then by observing these two equations, we easily guess that the phase between voltage and current is 5 degree. Okay, so if we plot this on this phasor diagram circuit, then suppose that this is time axis, and if we plot the phasor for the voltage, input voltage, then this is at omega t, this is at omega t. Okay, so this is V, inputted voltage, and this makes angle omega t. Now if we plot the phasor for the current, then we can easily obtain this makes omega t plus phi with this axis. So the angle for this is I, and this makes omega t plus phi. So the angle between current and the voltage, this is the phase of the current with respect to the voltage, this is phi. Okay, so this is a particular phasor circuit for the inputted voltage and current flowing through LCR series circuit. Now, as we know that the voltage drop across the resistor is in the same phase with the current flowing through the circuit, it means VR is always lying in the same phase of the current, but the voltage drop in the inductor is 90 degree forward with respect to the current. It means current lag behind by 90 degree. So with making 90 degree with the current axis, this represents the VL, inductor voltage. And the voltage drop across the capacitor is lag behind by a 90 degree of phase. It means current leads ahead by a 90 degree. So the phasor represent by the voltage drop across the capacitor is along this direction. Okay, so as we are seeing that VL and VC are up in opposite direction, so the resultant of these two will be obtained as the subtraction of from the larger one. It means if VL is larger than VC, then the resultant of these two will occur in this direction, and if VC is greater than VL, then the resultant of these two will occur in this direction. If VC is larger than VL, then the circuit, LCR series circuit, will be treated as capacitive circuit. But if VL is greater than VC, then the nature of this circuit will be treated as inductive circuit. Okay, so and resistiveness of the circuit is always present because resistor is always present. So what will be the resultant of this VR, VC and VL? This is V because this is the inputted voltage, and input voltage is divided into VR, VC and VL. So we can be expressed in the phasor form as V is equal to VR plus VC plus VL. So if we find out the resultant of this V, then V can be written as in the magnitude form VR square. Suppose that if you find out the magnitude, then the magnitude of this square and also this square, plus because this VC and VL are in opposite direction, so we can write it as VC minus VL square. Okay, so angle between VR and VL minus VC is 90. So more other terms, that is twice of VR dot VC minus VL into cos of 90. Cos 90 becomes 0, so that will be finished. So V square will be equal to VR square plus VC minus VL whole square. So if we find out what will the value of V, so this can be expressed as in this formula. Now if V can be expressed as Vm, this is the maximum input voltage, and this Vr is expressed as Vmr or Vrm, and Vc expressed as in Vc, Vcm, and VL is equal to VLm. It means when the input voltage reached at its maximum value, then the potential across the capacitor, resistor and the inductor will also be reached at its maximum value. So at this condition, Vm will be equal to Qm omega into Z, and this will be equal to Qm omega, that is Im into R, and this will be equal to Qm by C and this will be equal to qm omega square l. Okay, so after putting it, we can get that this will be equal to z, because qm omega will be cancel with each other. From here we get this will be equal to r square plus xc minus xl whole square. Okay, this is the impedance of the circuit. And as we are seeing that the angle phi is the angle between the input voltage and the current flowing through the LCR circuit, so this is the phase, and the value of this phi can be plotted on the graph as now the total potential drop across LCR series circuit is due to the impedance, that is Z, and the total potential drop across the resistor is due to R, and the total potential drop in inductor and capacitor due to VC minus VL. So this is due to XL and this is due to XC. So resultant of these two, XC minus XL lying in this direction. So this is XC minus XL, and this one is R, and this is Z. Okay, so angle between R and Z is phi. So if we make this a parallelogram, okay, so we can plot it as this is Z and this one is R, this is XC minus XL, so this angle is phi. So from here we get tan of phi is equal to XC minus XL by R. Okay, so here phi can be defined as power factor, and it can be discussed in our next lecture. Okay, so this is all about the LCR series circuit. Okay, till now, take care, thank you.